Today we have an analysis of the recent 2018 election polls. So essentially we're going to be going through a number of these polls and what it means for the 2018 election. So I know I recently did a video about this, but recently new polls have come out, and some by more top names than others. And some other polls that were taken before were done by less, sometimes online polls that were used as statistical data. And now we look at these polls done by some pretty big names like Fox News or Gravis or Quinnipiac, a number of these names that were very close to predicting the 2016 election. And also, if you want to talk about that, go to Real Clear Politics, go to the 2016 election, look at the no toss-up RCP average electoral map. It shows the Clinton victory 272. I believe to Trump's 266, and that would be giving her the states of Wisconsin, Michigan, and Pennsylvania, all three which Donald Trump won, and giving Trump the state of Nevada, which Hillary Clinton won. So only four states were wrong, according to opinion polling. So that's pretty interesting, isn't it? But again, we're going to go ahead and take a look at these 2018 election polls and what it means for the 2018 election. So I'm not going to throw out all polls. Just because a few polls were wrong in 2016 does not mean that all polls are invalid. And also, a lot of people try to take the polls and put them in the favor of their candidate, and then they'll disregard the other ones because fake news or fake polls, things like that. And again, that's not something that's beneficial to the discussion about politics, because it makes things more contested, more heated. People get angry at you faster, and that's not a good thing. Okay, when you look at a poll, yes, the Republicans are leading in the Georgia governor poll, but if you go to the same exact race here, people will disregard this poll because it shows a Democratic victory. Yes, it's possible for a Democrat to win in some of these Republican states, and just because a Democrat is winning does not mean the poll is fake. And in fact, if we look at this, Mason-Dixon's better than SurveyUSA at polls, so keep that in mind. Some polls are a little bit more accurate than others, and just because they agree with a certain candidate does not mean that they are 100% accurate, and just because they disagree with what you believe in does not mean that they are 100% inaccurate. So let's go ahead and go right into the polls. Saturday, July 21st, the Oregon governor race, actually a tie between the Democratic incumbent and the Republican challenger, which means that Oregon no longer becomes what 270 to win would classify as a likely state, which means it's probably between 5 to 10%. It could now become a toss-up state with an exact tie between the two candidates. I'm not saying it's going to be an exact tie, because a previous poll showed her ahead by 17%, but this candidate was not as known. Now he's as known, and she hasn't really improved. She lost 1% in the polls. She was just able to hold on to her base early on, and that's exactly what she's doing now. But this Republican candidate is gaining in a number of Oregon voters. So we go over to Friday, July 20th. We look at the Georgia Republican runoff race. I do expect Brian Kemp to win here against Casey Cagle. Before, Cagle was leading, and now Brian Kemp is consistently leading in the rest of the opinion polls. And also, if we look at this, these polls taken, both of them lead Stacey Abrams. But Brian Kemp gains a little bit more of the voters. Stacey Abrams also is able to capitalize and carry 1% more of the voters. I'm not saying it's a lot, but when it comes down to a close race, 1% to 2% could make all the difference, as it did in 2016. So we look at the Georgia governor race. Well, this one's not going to become the most contested race in the nation. We'll look at states like Maryland, Massachusetts, Vermont, New Hampshire. These states with Republican incumbents, where Democrats typically win here, Democrats possibly could target, but we could also say that Georgia could get close. It could become a toss-up state, but I'm not saying that the Democrats are going to heavily target it when they look in other states like Maryland and New Hampshire, where Republicans are very vulnerable to lose here, especially in a blue wave year, compared to focusing on some other areas where pundits already have rated these races as likely for either political party. But if Georgia and Oregon all of a sudden become toss-up states, that opens up the map to a number of other things. We're going to ignore approval polls because that's not something we're talking about now. So the Georgia governor race, same thing, runoff here, shows Brian Kemp ahead by 18%, just one day difference, but again, could be polling different parts of the state. We're not going to talk about the Wisconsin Senate or governor's race because it's not too important to the 2018 midterms as of right now. But we look at the West Virginia Senate race. Joe Manchin leads by 10%, done by a Republican polling group. Keep in mind, this is the polling group that showed Donald Trump winning in Michigan out of all of the polls. So I would say this one would probably be a little bit more accurate, but yes, it does lean a little bit more to the right, and it still shows Joe Manchin ahead by 10%. And if you look at some of these polls, if Joe Manchin does vote for Brett Kavanaugh, it shows that he would win by 18% in the Senate race amongst the same polling numbers. And if he doesn't, then it's a 2% victory for him. So regardless of how he votes, it seems like he possibly could win, but if he does vote in favor of Kavanaugh, it will be definitely beneficial to his reelection campaign. Looking at the New York Senate race, nothing different than what we normally see. The Democratic primary for the New York governor race, this is something that progressive Democrats probably aren't going to like because it's not showing any type of outsider candidate coming up and defeating the incumbent. The incumbent is going to defeat Cynthia Nixon in this race. So we're going to disregard the governor's race for right now, even though, yes, we do see Democratic victories. Obviously, we're seeing them because this is the state of New York. Again, disregarding President Trump's approval polls, but this generic ballot poll. This is something that's definitely beneficial to Democrats. Right now, Democrats are consistently leading in every generic ballot poll. So we're going to go back, but right now, the Democrats are currently leading by 7.7%, according to these polls. That's pretty good for the Democrats. So when we look at 2010, in that huge Republican wave year, Democrats led early up in the beginning. Republicans never led in these opinion polls. They were never able to hold on to this lead before. Democrats even had a double-digit lead. And then all of a sudden, they went up. They went to the 2010 ballot, and they lost a number of seats. Democrats have consistently led in the opinion polls, and now they're inching up slowly, which will probably reach around 9 to 10% when we reach the 2018 midterms, around the same margins for the Republicans back in 2010. Again, we're not looking at congressional approval, the direction of the country, but over here, in the California 48th District, a toss-up state, the Democrats currently leading by 2%. The Hawaii governor race, not much difference, but the incumbent is actually winning in the Democratic primary polls, which is something that's not normal to what we saw before. So we'll go back, and then we're going to go ahead and skip the Hawaii governor race because, again, that's not something that's vital to the outcome of the 2018 midterms. Monday, July 16th, the Florida Senate race. The most recent poll shows Bill Nelson ahead of Rick Scott by 4%. Tennessee Senate race, the same thing that we've been talking about for a long time. Phil Bredesen currently leads Marsha Blackburn. Again, something to note. New Jersey Senate race, this one could become contested. Bob Menendez only leads his Republican opponent by 2% in a state like New Jersey. He currently is one of the most unpopular senators in the United States coming from a Democratic state as a Democratic incumbent, as a Democrat up in the 2018 midterms. He's probably only inching by because this is a 2018 Democratic wave year. The Florida governor race, Ross DeSantis, he is currently leading in the Republican primary. Gwen Graham is currently leading in the Democratic primary. And the top two frontrunners shows the Democrats ahead of the Republicans. But in all other polls, it seems like the Republicans are doing pretty well against the lesser-known Democrats. So that's pretty good for the Democrats when it comes to the top two candidates that shows a Democrat ahead of a Republican. When we go over to the Tennessee governor race, whoa, look at this. We have the Democrats ahead by 4%, by 2% in these opinion polls. And also, these are between the two frontrunners in this poll by 4%, between the second, I guess you could call them, the runner-up for the governor race in the Republican primary. The Democrat only leads by 2, but against the front-runner, they lead by 4. So that's pretty considerable for the Democrats, being able to actually be ahead in some opinion polls. Yes, they're both under 40%. The Republicans probably are still going to win this race, but the Tennessee Senate race no longer is a likely state according to these polls and could become a toss-up state. So we're seeing a number of these states become toss-up states, along with Florida, which is already a toss-up, so I don't need to adjust the map there. Some of these polls are a tad bit older, but they still stand, and there's still something to note. Again, we're probably going to look over here. Montana Senate race, Rosendale versus John Tester. John Tester wins by 3%. Actually, if you look at the Seoul Congressional District opinion polls, which shows the Democrats ahead, that's also something to note as well. Just looking at a number of these polls down here, in Texas Senate race, Cruz plus 9, not something we didn't expect. Texas governor race, Abbott plus 10, not something we didn't expect. The Arizona governor race here, though. The current two front runners, the Democrat is leading by 1%, so the race no longer becomes likely, but a toss-up race. So a number of these opinion polls are showing that races really that are supposed to be likely or leaning in the certain area for a political party are now becoming toss-up races, and not just in the governor map. When we look at the Tennessee Senate race, when we look at the New Jersey Senate race, which should be safe for the Democrats this election season, the Hawaii governor race could get a little bit close in the Democratic primary, which it really shouldn't. It just goes to show that these polls are all indicating that these races are going to become extremely close. So thank you guys for watching this video. Comment down suggestions below, and I will see you all tomorrow.